everybody, Swapmoto. We're here today at Glen Helen. Something interesting going on. It's a question I get a lot when I'm at the track. Which bike should I buy, the 150 SX or the 250 SXF? So we set up a test today. We're going to have Pat Foster ride the two bikes, give you all the opinions on them. We got two 2020 motorcycles. We've added FMF power parts exhaust to each model. So it's going to be an interesting day. Check out the video if you're in the market for a new one. See what's the plus, minuses on each one. They're obviously going to be different between a two-stroke and a four-stroke. So just check out the review. There's going to be a lot of good feedback in this video.
Hey guys, this is Pat Foster with Swapmoto Live. We got a fun one today. Our buddy David O'Connor from KTM met us out here. We're doing a comparison. KTM 150 SX versus the KTM 250 SXF. We get questions all the time. Hey man, what's the best bike? What should I get? It really just depends on what you're doing. We kind of put our heads together and said, hey, let's do a lights bike comparison. Not really a shootout, just more of an informational, hey, what do you like? Where are you riding? And then maybe you can decide what's better for you. I'm gonna start with the 150. We don't talk about that bike a lot. It's kind of a cool bike. It's a niche bike for KTM. Man, I gotta tell you right off the bat, I was thinking the 250 was gonna be significantly faster. I was amazed at how fast this 150 is. This thing is so quick. It hits hard. It's easy to keep the revs up. A little bit more beef than a 125. Man, but it's so light. The power to weight ratio just makes this thing so much fun. It wants to wheelie out of corners. It feels light when you're on the straightaway. Good thing, bad thing, you know, the power's really good, the power's quick, but the bike also feels light and therefore a little disconnected from the track, a little busier, where when you're riding the 250, you can lug it out of the corners and roll it on a little bit. Not the case with the 150. You gotta be in the right gear, you gotta be diligent with your shifting, you gotta be aggressive. Man, if you do everything right on the 150, I think it's very competitive racing against a 250. But like I said, you're vulnerable to mistakes. You gotta be diligent with your shifting. You gotta be aggressive. Where the 250 kind of promotes a little smoother, almost lazier style. You can be a little bit, just not quite as aggressive. The 150 also favors an aggressive cornering style. You know, when it comes to cornering, man, the 250 SXF is a great cornering bike. It's excellent against the other 250s. Man, I don't think it corners nearly as well as the 150. As far as suspension goes, the 250 is plush. It feels smooth. And I think the setup is pretty similar, but the 150 is just so light that the bike feels a little skittery. It feels a little disconnected from the track. I had a hard time getting it to settle, maybe dial in some rebound, a little more rebound. I actually softened some clickers to try to get it to settle a little bit. You know, it really just depends on where you're riding. If I was racing all the time, you know what? I think I gotta go with the 250. But what bike am I gonna spend the most time on today? Definitely the 150. So much fun to ride. Especially when you're riding against 250s, it's like a chess match. You gotta go in a little bit harder into the corner, carry a little more speed, get your shifts, probably shift one or two times down more than you would on the 250. Rail the turn, and then get your shifts smooth. Man, it's just really a fun bike to ride. If I was just gonna buy a play bike, something I'm just gonna go out in the hills with, do a little trail riding, riding some tracks, race once in a while, I could absolutely be competitive on the 150 against the 250s, and that's the bike that I would buy. Just fun. If you see yourself doing a little bit more racing, maybe you're not quite as aggressive, you wanna just be a little smoother, a little more torque, man, the KTM 250 is an amazing bike, just period. So you really can't go wrong, but man, what a great idea. Really appreciate David O'Connor bringing us out here from KTM. Had a lot of fun. Guys, check it out. Check out both of those KTMs. You know, you really can't go wrong. Thank you very much.